Guys, I think I see a gazebo.
This is the end. Hold your breath and count to 10. Feel the earth move and then hear my heart burst again. Let the sky fall.
Good evening. Today, we're on the hunt for gazebos. Some of the most dangerous and vile creatures that slither this earth. Gazebos are
terrible.
Today, we are gonna stop these gazebos and make sure that they are captured for their crimes.
Moderate rock.
Welcome back to Gazebo Hunts. We're real close to gazebo, I can just sense it. Real close. You can just smell the stench of just awkward eighth grade parties and hot pockets. Gazebos are notorious for hot pockets. Some kids, they just cook them, they just bring their own microwaves and just cook them right on the spot. Disgusting creatures. Disgusting. Disgusting. One fun fact about gazebos, they're dangerous. Vile. Gosh. Come here. I've only seen these in the textbooks. It's a gazebo migration trail. Very rare. Very rare. This is good for us. We're near. I can smell the bamboo already. And the metal. We're close. Welcome back to gazebo hunting. And we have come across one of the most peculiar sights known to gazebo hunting, the gazebo burial ground. If the spooky music doesn't tell you enough, this place is incredibly spooky. Cold and gazebo-y. Very, very dangerous here. We followed the gazebo migration trail. I did sense a emotion of sadness here on that trail, and I believe this is the reason why. Gazebos come here to mourn. Gazebos are most dangerous when they mourn. Most dangerous. We are risking our lives here today to find evidence so you believe that gazebos are real. Hide the children. Protect their eyes. This could get dangerous.
What is that?
Welcome back to Gazebo Hunting. Here we have found the gazebo watering hole. Did you hear that? We are in hunting grounds. We are risking our lives to bring you the truth. Also sponsored by Animal Planet, because for some reason, gazebos are considered animals. Really, they're more like beasts. But look here, folks. We have gazebo meat. That's right. They are cannibals and carnivores at the same time. They're very ruthless. Just think, your child could be swimming in this mosquito and parasite infested lake. And what sneaks up right behind them? I'll tell you a clue, a gazebo.
Come here, Johnny. I got a snack, Johnny. Come here, Johnny.
What you looking at, kid? I'll gazebo you up. I'll gazebo you up.
Hey, kid, I got some candy. Do you want some candy? I got candy if that's what you want.
Welcome back to gazebo hunting. Here, I'm tricking the ducks / geese. If you're thinking that is food, this is what gazebos do. It's good for you. Don't worry, it's only dill pickle, it's fine. It's very natural. Found in the Everglades. Come here. It's fine. This is a lesson for all you gazebo non-aware travelers. This could be your children. Stupid ducks. But seriously, stay safe out there, folks. Welcome back. I'm gonna trek across the wild forest full of gazebo carnivores / cannibals, ruthless creatures we have stumbled across. One of nature's most terrifying sights. Yeah, folks. A gazebo trap. They come here slithering with their foundations dingling to attract their prey. And they lay these boards across unnatural lands to trap their prey. Notice the distinct architecture. Look at those lines. Tracks. Very, very horny animals. Mating season. It's dangerous out here, folks. One wrong step. And you're dead. Gazebos are real. Here. We have this terrible sign put here by gazebos. Thirsty, disgusting gazebos. Look with me. Is that what you want, Animal Planet? Gazebos. Stop building them. Despicable. Bloodthirsty. Gazebos. Crazy thing about gazebos, they're very sneaky, just like glaciers. You never know they're walking on them. Or next. We like to use camouflage, natural materials. Are you serious right now, Bill? On my Animal Planet premiere, are you gonna... Really? I am the star. Come on, baby. Come on. Do I have to tell Mom? This is why I dropped out of film school. Welcome back to gazebo hunting. Here, we have found a gazebo grave. That's right, I show no respect to gazebos. Here lies its final resting place. It probably lived a pretty good life. It might have had a few flaws, but it probably lived a good life. Shut up. You got what you wanted, Animal Planet. That's what Animal Planet does to people. And gazebos. It's not about the money no more. It's probably more than that. It's about the kids. The kids. And we have reached the end of gazebo hunting. Thank you for joining us. It's been a wild adventure. We thought we got close at one moment, maybe a little emotional. But we still prevailed. We still did the most important thing that gazebo hunting is all about, educating you. Come back again, and Animal Planet, please sponsor me for this video. I'm vegan. I only have a few dollars left. And watch out for gazebos. Hickory's butt crack! Gazebos.